Hey folks, this is Doug from blowback9.com. Today we're doing the Overmass Project, trying to see how much mass it takes to stop 9mm from cycling. And I think I may have found it for at least one of my uppers. I have over here a 9mm blowback upper with a 2.5-inch Macon Armory custom barrel. And that will not cycle with the amount of mass I have in this gun. Now this is the Overmass gun. What I have is an A2 buffer tube. I have an 11-ounce Midway USA buffer, 4 Kinshot spacers, each weighs 2.5 ounces, and I have a Claw Valley Precision bolt in which I've replaced the rear bolt mass with a tungsten bolt mass, giving it a total of 16.5 ounces. That means that in order for blowback 9mm to cycle in this gun, it needs to push 37.5 ounces, or over 1 kilogram, of mass back and forward. Now, the last round bolt hold open will not work, simply because with all this mass in the back, it actually is slightly short-stroked, and it overrides the last round bolt hold open. Again, we tried the 2.5-inch barrel, and it will not cycle 37.5 ounces, so I think we met the limit for that, and I'm not going to show you that because it just created these awful jams that took about 5 minutes apiece to try to unjam. I have some of the cheapest ammo you can possibly get. This is old Walmart Red Box Federal ammo, some of the weakest stuff you could probably find. So we're seeing what now a 5.5-inch barrel will do. I've already tried it, so I think I know what's going to happen. So here we go. 5.5-inch barrel, very weak range ammo, 115-grain Red Box Federal, originally from Walmart, and 37.5 ounces. Here we go. And no, I don't have the covers off of the sight because I really don't need it. I'm just pointed downrange right at the berm. Five rounds, and it cycles just fine. So I think we have our answer. With a 5.5-inch barrel, we could definitely do 37.5 ounces. I'm going to take some weight out and see if I can get that 2.5-inch barrel to cycle. Okay, I'm back. I have switched to muffs because I'm under a canopy and that is ridiculously loud under a canopy. These are the Kinshot weights. I have removed one and added some spacers into the back of the buffer tube so that we should get bolt hold open and we won't be risking breaking a bolt catch. Back to the 2.5-inch barrel. Again, we've got the weights inside. We have now 35 ounces. I'm going to see if this cycles with a 2.5-inch barrel, which is shorter than any commercially available standard 9mm barrel. The shortest you're usually going to get is about 3 inches, unless you go custom. Let's see if it works. There's one. Oh, and there's the jam. So it looks like 2.5 can't quite cycle it. Can we get that out and keep going? Maybe. Earlier, the jams with 37.5 ounces were just horrendous. You had to stop and use a screwdriver to try to unjam it. Yeah, it looks like the 2.5 can't quite handle it. Well, let's take one more weight out and see what we get. Okay, so I have rearranged the weights. I have now removed two of the Kinshot weights, two separate weights. So we are now down to 32.5, I believe. Let's see if a 2.5-inch barrel will cycle it. One. Two, three, four, and five. So it looks like we have our answer. 32.5 ounces, a 2.5-inch barrel can cycle it. What this tells us is that with a commercial available barrel, like a 3-inch or more, you should be able to cycle 32.5 ounces, which is really really tough to stuff into an AR receiver. You can see I'm using an A2 tube here. And I have a tungsten weight added to the bolt. So when someone tells you that XYZ buffer is too heavy for 9mm, I'd argue that point. Have a good one.